Well, hey folks, BC7 here. Welcome back to the channel and welcome to Farm Sim 15. If it's your first time here, well, thank you. Having an off day, are you? Just kidding. This is today a map review, and I'm sure a lot of you are going to recognize this just from where I'm standing. This was recommended to me by Jeremy Burnett. Although maybe recommended is a little strong. All he did, in fact, was left a link. Now, I'm going to assume perhaps, they didn't want me to just simply point and laugh, so natural assumption was to do a review. So this is the Old Family Farm. It is version 2 extended. Now, Old Family Farm has been around since FS13, and it has changed quite a bit since then. And yeah, there's a big sign right behind me dedicated to Bill St. Max, Farm Sim Saturday, blah blah. I mean, that's just what every YouTuber wants, is to advertise somebody else's YouTube while doing a review. Anyway, here we are. So this is the farm itself. It includes beefs, pigs, chickens, sheep, cows. Did I leave anybody out? I don't think so. I do believe it's all standard crops, as there are no multi-fruit mods required or used. So there we go. Yep, everything's straight up. We've got very few sell points, but that's okay because it's a small map. Wow, there's more than there used to be. I'll give it that. In fact, there's... Where the heck did they fit all of these? I believe there was, originally in FS13, there was actually one sell point. So, yeah, this Beihain feed, which as you see still takes pretty much everything. But, let's have a look around, shall we? Oh, let's look at the rest of the card first. Stock price for eggs, that's good. And here's our map. Old Family Farm used to be pretty much just this. This is what they've added. It is, I guess, quite a move up from what it used to be, but it is still, unfortunately, as I say, very, very flat. So, this used to work for storing grass. Probably still does. And this one was for silage. And we've also got a bin here. That building's been there since the very first iteration of the map. That's pretty cool. Same silo system too. This one's kind of neat. You tip in here and then pick up under each spout depending on what crop you want. To know which crop it is, you actually just go and look at the bag of seed on the ground. Wheat, right? Barley, canola, and corn. So that's kind of cool. As you can see, the cow pen and the water mod has been added, I believe. It certainly looks like a water trough, doesn't it? And through here with our Mr. Cow Milker and your funny looking cow. Alright, milk pickup is here. I'm not sure there's an actual drop off point. I thought milk pickup was at midnight, but we'll have a look as we go along. Here's our ladies out here, and here's their shed. There you go. Usual tippy trays. Nice little pond for them to practice their laps in. Excellent. Good job, cows. Ooh, it's a long way to your pit, isn't it? Think you gotta walk all the way over there just to have a poop, you poor thing. Here we've got wood chips. And this was hay storage, huh? Still is. Straw and Straw and hay, I guess. And then we've got sugar bots and potatoes. Oh, well, or potatoes and sugar bits. Whichever way you want to look at it. One nice improvement. These no longer have collision. I'm really happy about that. Because I don't know what it was with this particular bush. But see that very last leaf sticking out there? Oh, yeah, that will stop a 600 horsepower combine dead in its tracks. It was just hilarious. I mean, if you so much as touched your mirror going around a corner, these things would grab you and just eat you. So, seeds and ferts can be purchased there. Here it is. And then there's these teleparts, so that you can go to the other farms in the area. But, it is a bigger map than it used to be, so maybe that would actually serve a purpose. As I said, all of your fields are very small, very square, especially the old ones. And yeah, you'd quickly find it get really boring trying to do it with gear of this size. You know, here's a minute and a half's work. Do own a fair few fields to start. I'm just going to cut through here and show you. Here's our piggy penny. Hello, pigs. And this, of course, is where we do our pick up and drop off. Ooh, the door opened. Oh, my. Quick, close the door. Them some mean-looking huggies. Oh, yeah. Can dump your earth fruits in there. There's where we get the poop de piggies. There's where they make their milkshakes. Alrighty. So let's head down the road. And here is sort of our major cell group. This used to be, as I said, pretty much the only cell point on the map. There's sugar beet and potato sales. This is the Bayhayan feed. And they do still buy pretty much everything. There's your straw disposal, or bale disposal. There's your garden center shop sign. Vehicle shop on this side. Selling point for wool. Selling point for your vehicles. And when you buy a vehicle, she appears here. And I thought, rather than the perfect purple pickup, we would grab something a little more toward the map. Alrighty, let's head out here, shall we? Do the slow tour. Alrighty. Here's to be the storage area here. This is, I guess, a second farm. And it says there's a refueling point here, too. Okie dokie. Let's head across the bridge and go visit the lovely town. The pig farms that way. Nice that it has signage. Oh, that's left over from FS13. The world's most annoying train noise. And, oh, you know, you never see a train, by the way. It's just that the whole time you're anywhere near this part of it, this thing screams and screams and screams. So, here we go. Place to drop your mean, nasty hogs. And yeah, there you do require an animal transport to drag your huggies down here and sell them. So, there's your bank. You can sell eggs here, and I believe, like I said, this is for... Oh, that's all it's going to tell us. So that's the sell point for eggs. Alrighty. Yeah, I don't want to go anywhere near that train again. Up the hill. And I'm entirely not sure. Perhaps this is a drop-off for the milk? I don't have my console loaded, so I can't actually look for triggers. Huh. Well, I don't know. That's sort of what it looks like to me, is a very low-grade pickup point for milk or sell point. So, that may well be. You can feel free to correct me if I'm wrong, as that's probably the case. Just have a look at the back of the hog shop here. Ah. Okay, so one would be... Here's our rails dropper. What the heck was it called? Sorry, I forgot the name of it. It was rails something. Rail line. So there's your rail line drop. Alrighty. Taking a quick cruise through town. We can go up here, and as you can see, there's a little tiny forest area up here. It actually just does a loop and comes back down on the same spot. So we'll do an even smaller loop. There we go. So that's one of the small forest areas. I think what we're going to have to do here is go over a little further. This bridge. And there's the train whistle again. And we'll find we've got some more property back here. Yeah. Look at the big map. You can see where we're headed in here. We have our sheep farm up there. You can see all the woolly crunchies in the background. All the usual amenities. Hello, ladies. And the actual wool collection. You gotta go inside that fence around the other end of the barn. Over to here, and then we get to pick up your wool pallets there. And there's another teleport point back there. Those little bobbing belobbings. Here's your sheep pen. Baw, baw, baw. Little bit of vehicular storage, and down the road we go. Whoops. Let's get on this road. Is that... Whoops, what does that say? Chew male pouch tobacco. Oh, well, alrighty. Let's continue on up the road, shall we? Go visit the first extension. And... I'll be honest, this struck me as being just that. You know, a completely sort of artificial extension. The map used to end right there at the end of that sheep farm. So, Riverside. So, they're even still using the same trees they had in FS13. That's funny. Alright, so here we have Riverside, and, well, so much for the small old equipment, because here you can see it's completely opposite. The fields are huge. There's still, you know, absolutely square, absolutely free formed of any sort of obstruction or thought, but yeah, they'll work. And I'm thinking I should have got something a little faster. Because, well, quite frankly, I hadn't realized that these back parts were going to be so far apart from each other. They looked a little closer, so. There we go. Now we'll be able to get to them. Unbelievable. Oh yeah, this was always fun. Oh, it didn't give me the warning this time. Impressive. Impressive. Huh. Alright. Lots of little touches like the ducks and stuff, and that was really neat too, because as I said, when this map originally came out, you either did one of the big maps, or, you know, and used big gear. If you wanted to use the classics stuff, and even though FarmSim released their own classics pack, which is recommended for this map, by the way, at least for that portion of it, there wasn't a lot you could do. You know, you either worked one or two fields right beside the farm, or the whole thing very rapidly became quite overwhelming. You know, so here's the McCain place. One would imagine they would buy, oh, I don't know, potatoes? So. Alrighty. And in behind it, we have, what is that? Ritterbrau? Huh, wonder if that's a real type of beer. And behind that, we have what they call another farm. Or at least vehicular storage. Is that water or fuel? What does that say? Diesel, okay. You can get gas, place to store, that sort of thing. Although from what I've seen, there appears to be only one crop storage. And that's that little one back on the farm. I mean, there's all kinds of silos here, but I believe these are sell points, are they not? Yeah, this is the thing for the taters. It's all just made to look really big. Really big. Alright, here we go. The bio... Oh. Maybe not, actually. Oh, here we go. This is a place for pickup. Here. Huh, odd, there's pigs on both sides. I would have thought you get to pick up both the pigs and the beef there. Hmm. Then we've got the canola plant. The wheat mill. Wow. We buy your crop. We buy your crap, yeah. The rest of us just put up with it. Some kind of really bizarre forestry stuff going on here. Yeah. Wow. They sure ain't got woods like this where I live, man. It would have taken me an hour to walk from there to here. kind of reminds me of the bush back in Ontario. You could walk around all day out in the woods, and it was pretty much effortless. You just had to walk between the trees. Of course, here in BC, it's a little bit different. It's, walking around in the bush is never effortless. Never. And here, if I can find a way in, there we go. We have another farm installation, this one containing... should have our beefs. There they are. Hello, roly polies. I know those are wiggles and waggles, but that's okay. Let's move next door. And Here we have a fully functional farm with all of the storages bits in place, a place to buy fuel, you can get your seed, your ferts, your water, everything you need. And next to that we have the sugar beet plant. Ta-da! Alrighty, now head out to the main road. This truck, I tell you, it just does not like plant. Yeah, we did all of those. That's the different plants all in a row. And I think this should... Yeah, this will take us up to the other new extension, as it were. And this is sort of the same thing on an even more giant scale. You know, here's where you can put in several hundred hectare type cornfields and such for your biogas production, which is what's up here. Got our pits, got our pots, and got our put-ins. And yes, you will require, as you can see, to either install a ramp or use a front loader. You'll be no tipping trailers into those. They're 8 feet off the ground. And here we have our final farm with all the same stuff on the other two. Grain storage, in fact, the same grain storage. And as you can see, the equipment out here is, well, considerably bigger. This is also where we hide our chickens. Buck, 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 buck. So, as you can see, it comes complete with ginormous kit. There you go. Suitable for doing ginormous fields. Hey, I take it I didn't actually need to install Animation Map Trigger. There's no mods mentioned, actually, that are required with it, so... other than they do suggest... there we go, there's our troughs, okay. They do suggest, like I said, that you download the Farm Sim 13 Classics Pack, which has been, of course, redone for Farm Sim 15. But there you go, guys. Yeah, that's all that this is, isn't it? Yeah, okay. So there you are. That is Old Family Farm version 2 extended. So, thanks to Jeremy for suggesting the map. It is an interesting concept, I guess, the way that they've done this, where you go from the much smaller fields to the sort of medium-sized stuff, to being able to actually get over here and jump in the great big honkin' kit. And so, yeah, it should pretty much settle any sort of farming urge you have. As I said, my only real complaint with it is everything is so flat and so square. But I know a lot of guys like these sort of maps because they're more into the course play, or they like the hired worker end of it. And, well, yeah, there's nothing worse than sticking a hired worker on an odd-shaped field and going, there you go, man, do the best of it. Because, well, their best is, frankly, almost as good as my worst. So, there you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed the map review. The link will be in the description down below. It's available over on FSUK, amongst other places. Like I said, it's not exactly new to the world. So, there you go. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, now's a good time. Feel free to share and favorite all those YouTubey things. But above all, take care of each other, folks. This has been Species 7 for Farm Sim 15 and the Old Family Farm. Ciao for now.